Dear learners, today we will be studying an important lesson, Society, Community, Association and Institution. We will be learning the concepts and definitions of society and community. We will be trying to understand or find out the similarities and differences between society and community. We will be explaining the concept of association and institution, state the distinction and relationship between association and institution, and also find out the importance of these concepts in the study of social life. Learners, we all know and we all stay in society where the relationships are through web of social relationships, and every individual is closely or integrally linked with the society. So, in this lesson, we will be studying society and different aspects of society. Now, what is a society? When we learn about society, how do we understand what is society or what is the meaning of society? McIver and Page, in their book, In Society, they gave a definition of society, that it is a system of usages and procedures, of authority and mutual aid, of many groupings and divisions, of controlling of human behavior and of liberties. So, learners, society is a system where individual has a relationship with the larger society, and society has a system of procedures which members follow, and there are social norms where members who reside in the society follow, and there are controlling systems in the society where social behavior is controlled, and many groups and divisions of human individuals or their behavior is present in the society which are controlled by certain institutions. So, society largely means a system where people stay together and are linked together and which is governed by certain norms and procedures. So, people follow a certain normative pattern or procedure. Now, what are the characteristics of a society? The main and important characteristic of a society is likeness and differentiation. There is a likeness among people in the society. Certain people know each other in the society, and there is also differentiation. People are different from each other. Certain people do not know each other, but they are members of the same society. Interdependence is also an important characteristic of the society. People are interdependent for their activities upon each other, for their activities or to carry out any of their duties. For example, in any kind of society, we have different institutions like the economic system, like the political system, like the religious system, like the legal system. All these systems are interrelated for the functioning of the whole society. So, interdependence means different parts of society are linked together for the functioning of the entire whole society. The third characteristic of society is cooperation and conflict. Certain people in the society cooperate with each other for performance of certain tasks, and also there is conflict in the society. Do not people have a conflict or tensions between themselves in society? They may not agree upon certain points, or there might be disagreement between members of the society. Hence, there is a conflict, or hence there is a social conflict. So, every society has undergone many tensions, many conflicts in the past. So, conflict and cooperation are perennial features of any society which is existing. Now, let us see and understand what is a community. A community generally means a small territorial group which has all aspects of social life. Or you can say a community is a group which has got a well-defined boundary, and people have different aspects of social life are included in the community. Now, Ferdinand Tönnies who was a German sociologist, he contributed immensely to the field of sociology in 19th and 20th centuries, and he classified the community and society into two types, the Gemeinschaft and the Gesellschaft. So, as per Tönnies' classification, we can see that community and society are termed as Gemeinschaft and Gesellschaft. So, when we see the difference, a community may be a smaller one and a society is a larger one. So many communities can be a part of one society. So one society can hold together many communities within it. So when we study in detail or try to understand in detail the types of communities, we can see that there are different types of communities which is there in our society, and we can see that according to Tony's theory, a community could be defined as a group of people who have shared or common bonds around traditions, beliefs and objectives. And Tony's used this to describe people that actively work together to maintain their bond and further their goals. So any member in a community would be having some community sentiment and would be having some common goals for the pursuit of the community interests. What are the examples of Gemeinschaft, which is a community? A good example would be a church or a religious institution. In this case, those that attend the church on a regular basis have formed relationships with other attendees and have bonded around their shared beliefs, values and traditions. All of them belong to one religious philosophy, or all of them follow one religious philosophy or have one religious belief. So they are bound together or close-knit in one community. There tends to be some sense of support and collectivity in these types of environments that foster a feeling of togetherness and belongingness. So community members have with them a feeling of togetherness and belongingness among them. So a specific characteristic of a community would be we feeling. So members of the community are closely linked together and there is a sense of community sentiment. We feeling is a community sentiment. There is a sense of community sentiment which binds all the members in the community together. What is a Gesellschaft? A Gesellschaft is a society. So in the Gesellschaft, relationships tend to be informal and impersonal. In both Gemeinschaft and Gesellschaft, or community and society, the individual member plays a critical role or plays an important role. In the former, or in Gemeinschaft, the person has space to fulfill personal needs and goals, like attaining a sense of belonging to a community and contributing to the lives of others. As a member of the Gesellschaft or a society, the individual contributes to the overall functioning of the larger society by participating in the economy and general stability of the society. Now, the specific characteristics of the community, as we see, it refers to an aggregate of individuals. There should be a group of individuals. It should have a definite territory. The members should have a strong we feeling or community sentiment amongst themselves. It is created spontaneously over a period of time. It has more permanence or endurance than groups which are created for specific purpose. Community serves wider ends. So community living has got a boundary. People have been staying in community for longer period of time and they are bound by collective sentiments or community sentiments. So communities have more endurance, are more permanent since they have been there or existing there for longer periods of time. Like the tribal community, as we see the tribal community, members in a particular tribal community, they stay together since generations, long historical past. Learners, after we learnt about the society and community, now let us learn, understand what is an association. An association is a group of people who come together and get organized for fulfillment of specific goals or purposes. So association is deliberately formed. It's a deliberate group which people form for fulfillment of certain goals or purposes. Ferdinand Tonnis also talked about these, like for example in Gesellschaft, where relationships are individualistic, impersonal, competitive, calculative and contractual, often employing explicit conceptions of rationality and efficacy. In an association, we have a group of people who come together and they build a relationship for a specific purpose. It may not be necessary that they have some collective sentiments, but they are collectively organized for the pursuit of common collective goals. So relationships are important or rationally framed in terms of an association. An example of an association would be a sports club or a music club. What would be the characteristics of an association? It consists of individual, the people are organized, it is governed by certain rules and regulations, activities are carried out to attain certain specific goals. So we learned that today that associations are specifically formed or organized by people for the pursuit of certain goals, and there are certain rules, fixed specified rules, which govern the functioning of these associations, and specific activities are carried out to accept or follow these goals. Learners, now let us move to another aspect, which is an institution, or to understand what is an institution which exists in a society. Institution refers to an established order comprising rule-bound and standardized behavior patterns. The term institution is widely used to describe 1. Social practices that are regularly and continuously repeated, sanctioned and maintained by social norms and have a major significance in the social structure. Secondly, they are established patterns of behavior. Institutions are regarded as general units that incorporates a plurality of rules. Now, in sociology, many scholars or many sociologists have contributed towards understanding institutions. For example, Karl Marx has tried to understand economic institutions through the method of capitalism. Max Weber, in his study of Protestant ethics and spirit of capitalism, has tried to correlate two institutions, the economic institution and the religious institutions. Now, let us see how different institutions have an important role to play in the society. Now, when we look into the types of institutions in the society, we see one of the prominent and important institution is economic institutions, which serve to produce and distribute goods and services. For example, we have agriculture and industry. Sociologists like Marx and Weber talked about capitalism, like Marx talked about the economic institution in the capitalistic framework. He talked about capitalism as a system where two classes existed, the bourgeoisie and the proletariats, and there was difference or inequality between the two classes in an economic order. Like to one class, the bourgeoisie was the exploiter and the proletariats were the exploited class. So class struggle happened towards the goal of a socialistic society. So, economic institutions or capitalistic institutions or capitalistic society, which Marx related with the economic institutions, played a prominent role not only in the growth and development of the economy, but they had a different aspect also. How differences were created in these institutions was also an important aspect which was dealt with by sociologists. Similarly, Max Weber also talked about the economic institutions in his study of the Protestant ethics and spirit of capitalism, and he tried to correlate the Protestant spirit with the capitalistic spirit. People of the Protestant religious philosophy, they were more prone to work to maintain the economic order. So, economy became very important in many of these writings of the sociologists in long past, and economic institutions have evolved over a period of time. Recently, we have also seen how major transformations in the economic institutions have been taking place. For example, we saw the whole monetary institution in India when we had the demonetization program by the government, and we saw how it impacted the economic institutions. We recently had the goods and services tax, that is also an important aspect of a well-functioning economic institutions, where we have a single unified taxation system, and that had a prominent impact in the economic behavior of people. So now, for exchange of goods and services, we have a unified taxation system in the country. So economic systems or economic institutions are extremely important as they contribute towards the economic development and the growth of any society. When we look into social institutions, we have important social institutions like the marriage, the family and the kinship. We all know that family is a close-knit bond where people get socialized for pursuit of certain societal norms, and there are different patterns of socialization. Similarly, marriage is a social institution which brings about two families in contact with each other so that they fulfill, as members of society, they are knit into a relationship network and they fulfill certain social norms which is expected from them as members of the society. Similarly, another social institution is the kinship network, which refers to a whole range of relationships which exist between people, and there are lot of intricate aspects or personal aspects of these relationships, and many cultural patterns or many cultural determinants are formed through kinship bonds. Then we have another institution, the political institution, which means we regulate the use of and access to power. The political institutions are extremely important because they are treated as the decision makers or the decision making institutions in the entire country. For example, we have the whole issue or whole idea of the judiciary. We have many governing bodies, local governing bodies like the Panchayati Raj institutions, which provide reservations for people in grassroots democracy, specifically women, through the 73rd and 74th Amendment Act. So, political institutions not only help in maintaining or not only regulate power or access to power, they also bring about empowerment of people by empowering masses like the women, who have been in long past been deprived of many decision making positions in the country. Through political institutions like Panchayati Raj institutions, they have a say in the decision making process. Then we have the educational institutions like schools and colleges, which are extremely important and contributing towards the nation building process of the country. Every student who is a citizen of this country is a part of educational institution. Like the government of India has the right to education, which is free and compulsory education till 14 years of age. So, education becomes a mandate and extremely important for any country, for any government or any society which looks after the well-being and betterment of their people. So, education institutions play an important role for making good citizens of the country or making responsible citizens of the country. Then we have the religious institutions. The religious institutions are actually formulated or built in for the pursuit of certain religious philosophy or pursuit of certain religious norms. People who follow a particular religion or are members of a particular religion, they belong to religious, different religious institutions, and through these institutions they try to propagate, practice and profess their religious ideology. So, religious institutions are based on a particular religious ideology. Then we have cultural institutions. These are extremely important institutions because they deal with a nation's culture, a nation's cultural heritage, and these institutions are involved through artistic activities, music, dance. Like we have dance clubs, we have the National School of Drama in Delhi, and we have many other institutions. So, cultural institutions enable the country in professing and practicing or taking forward the cultural, rich cultural heritage and transmitting the cultural heritage to other parts of the globe or making people understand the cultural institutions in a particular country. So, learners, today we learnt about important institutions which are operating in a society, namely the economic institution, the social institution, the political institution, the education institution, the religious institution, the cultural institutions. These institutions are extremely important in governing social behavior and directing the way of social phenomena. Every individual who is a member of the society is a part of any of these institutions, and the institutions have well-designed specific roles, and there are actors, there are people, there are members of society who play a specific set of roles in a particular social institution, and they contribute towards the maintenance of the whole society or contributes towards the growth and betterment of the society by being members of these institutions. So, learners, today we learnt about this important lesson on society, community, association and institutions, and these are very important aspects as a members of society. We have to learn about these important aspects because they play a prominent role in governing our human or social behavior. So thank you learners for today, and till we meet for the next important lesson in sociology. Thank you.